Hello, everybody. Today, in our lecture, we'll end of network flows algorithm. Outlines. We'll talk today about time bound for different algorithms, multiple source and multiple sync network, maximum biparity matching, edge disjoint paths, and maximum flow with special constraints. So this is table around time bound for different algorithms. We have here the complexity for different algorithms, okay? Just to read, okay? Example, Ford is complexity M square U. M square is the number of edges. U is the maximum capacity. Ford, Edmond, M square log U. Edmond Carr, and so on, and so on, and so on. Okay? Okay. So now we'll talk about if we have, for example, a big company has several factories and several warehouses. Okay? عنده كذا مصنع، ست مصانع. Okay? عم تخزن البضاعة تبع هالست مصانع بثلاثة warehouses, three warehouses. Six factories, okay, and three warehouses. So this is called multiple source. البضاعة عم تطلع من هون ومن هون ومن هون ومن هون ومن هون. Okay, multiple source and multiple sink. البضاعة اللي عم توصل على T1, T2, T3 ما بعرف من وين من ست مصانع. Okay, and in the middle we have any nodes. Okay, and this is are the capacities. Okay. If we have this special case in network flows, and it's not special case, a big companies عطول عندهم هالشي كذا مصنع كذا warehouse. So هذا called multiple source, multiple sink. How we can solve it in network flows algorithms? We don't have one source and one sink. Here we have multiple source, multiple sink. So to solve this problem, just adding super source with infinite weight cost, infinite here, super source, infinite, and adding super sink T with infinite capacities here. So we add super source with infinite capacity and super sink T with infinite capacity. Then we can solve it as you want, or any algorithm network flow. Okay, you can solve it with any network flow algorithm, Ford, Edmond, Porsche, label, whatever. So you can solve it now. Okay, so this is the solution: virtual source, virtual sink to solve this network. Okay, this is okay. Any question here? Okay, it's easy. So now we'll go to maximum biparity matching. What does it mean? Here we have network flow without directed edges. Undirected graph, vertex edge. We have now vertex edges, undirected edges is a biparity graph if we have this. V vertex can be partitioned into left union right. If we can partition the network by two sub network, left and right, such as all edges go between L and R. The nodes in L in left, no connection between them. And the nodes or vertex in right, no connection between them. Just connection between the vertex in L and the vertex in R, right or left. Okay, in L, في node zone, في vertex, ما في connection. هون ما في connection بين بعض. Assume every vertex has at least one incident edge. Okay, لازم على القليل كل edge هون عنده edge. كل node عنده edge. So a set of edges M belongs to E edges is a matching in GVE if for all V belongs to E, at most one edges of M is incident on V. We'll see the graph. The optimization problem will be given a bi-party graph GLU union RE, find a matching of maximum cardinality. So example here, like this. Like this. We have here a network. We split it. We organize it like left network and right network. Okay. In condition with the vertexes inside the left network inside, no connection between vertexes. Also, the nodes or vertex in the right network, no connection between this vertex, but you must connect between left and right. So the edges, the connection will be only from left to right. Okay? This is called bi-party graph. And every vertex has edge. Every vertex has edge. Okay? So this is called bi-party graph. The solution of this, how we solve it. A bi-party matching, it's maximum. So example here. Example application for this, dating agency. Left is woman, right is the man. No relation between man, no relation between woman, okay? But we have relation between woman and man. So an edge indicate potential compatibility. Want to do as many matches as possible. Example here, if we have this by party, left woman, right man, or inverse, we solve this by, like before, adding super S and adding super T. But now in this matching, we put all the capacities one. Unit capacities to each edge. So all the capacities here are one. So we make the any network flow algorithm to solve it. So this is, we have this algorithm. Dating agency, بتحط الداتا لما يجوزوا عروس وعروس وعريس في كتير ويبسايتات هيك, بتحط انت شو بدك بمواصفات, بتحط هي شو بدها بمواصفات من الشاب, وانت شو بدك بمواصفات من البنت, فبيعملوا ماتشنج بهذه الطريقة, بيستعملوا الجوريزمات كمان نتوك فلو, ففينا نعمل ماتشنج, نعمل كومباين او ماتشنج للعروس والعريس. هذا اكزامبل. اوكي. Also بالفيسبوك لما يقول لك suggestion friend, بكون friend of your friend, يعني مثل AI algorithm, كأنه يعني كأنه. So any question here? In this slide, in this maximum matching as maximum flow. Okay. Now we'll learn another thing. Okay. This lecture I summarize all other network flows. So very fast. Okay. So we have algorithm here called edge disjoint path. Two paths are edges disjoint if they have no edge in common from S to T. Assign unit capacity to every edge, like here. S, 3, 4, 7, 7, 6, T. في عنا الأدج red, هيدا اسمه path 1. وعنا الpath blue, path 2, S, 2, 3, 7, T. ما في common edges. كل واحدة منفصلة عن الثانية. أكيد common node, أكيد common node, بس ما في common edges. Okay? So, theorem said, maximum number edge disjoint ST paths equals maximum flow value. هرجع عيد. In this kind of networks, the capacity to every edge is unit capacity to every edge. One. Same capacity, 1 or 10 or 20. Same capacity for all edges. Okay? We can solve this by this theorem to find different paths edge disjoint passes. No common side or edges in all passes. As you can see here, we have only two paths. So the maximum flow equal two. We have two paths, maximum flow equal two. Because here the edge is indirect, is inverse here. 6-2 inverse, 5-3 inverse. So theorem said maximum number of edge disjoint ST pass equal minimum size of an ST cup. Like here, the same example, same network. 5-3 is inverse, 6-2 is inverse. So we don't have these two edges. We remove them. So we have only two passes, okay? أو إذا بتذكروا المينيموم سايز مينيموم كات نقطع 2x2 ذا نتورك باي 2 سكشن نقطع بيطلع قاطع بس 2 edges 1 1. اوكي اذا اليونيتي هون 1 1 1 2 يعني ماكسيموم فلو هون 2. فهذا تيورم عم بياكد التيورم اللي قبل. اوكي اني كويشن هير جاست انفورميشن اباوت something. Okay, now maximum flow with special constraints. Till now all network flows assume the capacity will be integer. What if the capacity are non-integer capacities like rational capacities or real number capacities? شو بيصير في فواصل بالكباسيتي؟ كيف بده يحل النتورك فلو؟ الالجوريزم كيف بده يحلها في decimal points؟ شو بيعمل؟ So if rational capacities, الاسم بتخلص, okay, rescale them to integers by multiplying by the common multiply. إذا في فواصل بس الفواصل هون rational numbers like 3.5, it's rational, 3.5 is rational, okay. إذا لقينا common factor بيناتهم يحولهم كلهم لانتجرز ساعتها بنحله عاد. It's easy. Rational capacities, it's easier than real capacities. Okay? Or assume rounding up or rounding down. Is a 3.9, we put 4. With a 3 point or floor or ceiling, we can take just the integer part. We make assumption. Is a rational capacities, we make assumption that is a 3.8, put 3. سيف سايد ما تحطها 4 ما فينا نزيدها لا ما فينا نزيدها لانه ما بيقطع الكاباسيتي تبعها فبنعملها فلور في هذا الطريقه نحولهم كلهم فلور يعني بناخذ الكوشن بارت بس بنترك الفاصله هيدي فكره ريل نمبر كاباسيتيز ديفيكلت تو هاندل صعبه الفواصل ما بتنتهي بالراشنال فيك تلاقي فاكتور تجمعهم كلهم كانتجر فيك بينما بالريل نمبر الديسيمال نمبر ما بينتهي انفينايت difficult to handle and the algorithms will not finish but the computer deal with the real number and store them in memory as rational number هون في بعض الـ OS فينا نحول الريل نمبر ل rational number inside the memory RAM ما في شيء اسمه infinite decimal number float number in the RAM always real number in the RAM always will be at the end rational لما نحفز بقلب الميموري ما بي الفواصل تنتهي بالميموري في عنده 6 digit only بالميموري عنده 0.6 digit or 8 6 or 8 digits so it's fixed so automatically real number capacity okay transfer to rational then we solve it by the method we solve it before so this is special cases in network flow. Also, if we increase or decrease some capacities to different edges, but these edges are not bottleneck edges, then the maximum flow will not change. If after you solve any network and you have the optimal network, if you change increase or decrease the capacities for non-bottleneck edges, so the maximum flow will not change. Okay? Because always the bottleneck edges is lowest capacities inside the network. Bottleneck edges are the lowest capacities inside any network. If you choose other than this bottleneck edges, no change in the maximum flow network. But else, if the minimum cut edges increase or decrease, here we talk about bottleneck edges here. Minimum cut edges means bottleneck edges, then the maximum flow will increase or decrease as much as the bottleneck edges or minimum cut edges change. إذا غيرنا بالكاباسيتي بالبوتلنك طلعناهم واحد أو اثنين فالأكيد الماكسيم فلو حيطلع واحد أو اثنين أو نزلناهم أو طلعنا. Okay? So this is our special cases inside network flows. Okay? And of your chapter network flows algorithm. Any question here? Any question? Okay, so I will stop recording.